My charge is obviously hitting the cutting edge side of the situation. Evidence-based has been given with some of the other lectures, and I think it's exciting for the surgeon to have these opportunities with regards to cutting edge technology. But the key for the surgeon is to evaluate very carefully these new technologies and determine whether, in fact, there are significant improvements that warrant this early transition to the new technologies. Now, there are several things that can be considered worthwhile and would be a rationale. One would be speed of bone formation. Another aspect would be predictability of bone formation. The elimination of autogenous bone harvesting would be another indication. This obviously leads to a reduced surgical morbidity, and in the end gives us a much bigger cost reduction in terms of postoperative visits and the time involved in the surgical harvest. What I'd like to do today is talk to you a little bit about cellular allografts and hopefully let you see these potential benefits with this, which allows you to move towards use of such cutting-edge technology, maybe before we have the evidence base that we do have with some of the other technology that historically we've used. So the outline will simply be a review of stem cell biology, just kind of what the appeal is, why we would want to include cells in our grafts. The brief literature evidence, because again, there is a limited amount of evidence with this new technology. So therefore, I think it's relevant to show some implant case examples, some histologic evidence, and then we'll also look at periodontal case examples because it is something I've used both in implant reconstructive work and periodontal work. Optimal graft materials have all three aspects, as was so nicely outlined by Tara in the last presentation, the osteoconductive, osteoinductive, and the osteogenesis side. One of the things that we learned early on with the use of some of the bone morphogenetic proteins is that you did have to recruit the cells, and so the cells would be coming from the lateral wall. This shows a sinus augmentation, and you can appreciate the upper left where we have no bone formation, and as you move around, you'll see that the bone formation is coming from the walls because that's where the cells have been recruited from. Now, cellular enhancement of the bone augmentation surgery can be achieved in a variety of mechanisms. One would be autogenous bone from extraoral harvest. Another would be intraoral harvest, although there's a very limited amount of bone cellular contribution from intraoral augmentation. And primarily, you're going to be getting this if you're going to the tibia or the iliac crest with autogenous bone. There has been a push towards autogenous cell purification and amplification, where one can harvest through bone marrow aspirates or iliac crest material and the harvesting of stem cells and the use of the patient's own stem cells through this purification and amplification. There are cellular allografts without any cell manipulation, and this is what I'm going to focus primarily on today. And the product that I have the most experience with is called OsteoCell. Another one that has come onto the market recently is called Trinity Evolution. There are also cellular allografts now available with cell manipulation, AlloStem, which is a pure stem cell population that is used with an allograft.